Okay. Good morning, WFD. Good morning, Team Everest. Wow, it's a very delightful moment for me to be here. And I welcome all of you to our daily, weekly training. Today, I'm going to be your MC. Those who do not know me, I'm Dan Mugubi, Dr. Dan Mugubi from Texas, SMD from Texas. And my SMD is Beatrice Oduor. To get started, I would encourage everyone to turn on your camera so that you can really engage yourself with us. If you can, please turn on your camera. Don't hide. We are a family here. So we're going to have a very wonderful training today. So pay attention. Very good speakers. And I really would like everyone to turn on your camera and pay attention. Okay, so to start off this evening, we're going to have speakers, and I'll start with the newest, one of the most outstanding person who has just clinched 100K. In other words, this associate has made 100,000 in the last 12 months. So all of you, please help me to have the first speaker. Charisma.
Hello, good evening. Good morning, Team Everest. Thank you so much, Dan. I am so excited to be here. I'm so fired up and so pumped up. It feels so good to be here in this training. And I'm so excited to share to you what I'm learning right now regarding comprehensive financial planning. So my name is Charisma Laryosa. I'm from Chicago, Illinois. And my SMD is Madel Baroma under the leadership of Maricel and Kim Boyana. All right. So let me know if you can see my screen right now. All right. Okay. So I just want to, share what I'm learning right now with you guys. And it's regarding, comprehensive financial planning for our clients. Okay, so when I am sitting with a client, right, for the first, personal financial needs analysis, we want to make sure that I am providing them a firm financial foundation. Okay, so I want to start with protection. First of all, I want to make sure that, our partners, our client are properly protected, that their insurable need is being met. Okay. And then after that, of course, we want to help them attack their debts or do debt management. And then after the protection, after the debt management, we want to help the client establish their emergency fund, which is usually a three to six months of their expense, okay? And then after we are able to help them with their protection, with debt management and emergency fund, then we can help them with their investment. That's when the time that they are, max funding their IULs, right? We want to also help them with their investments. So let me just go to the next slide. Okay, I understand that not all of us here are securities licensed, right? But, we have prospects, clients, or even partners that sometimes will ask us, like, what can we offer aside from IUL, aside from fixed index annuities, aside from term insurance, and of course, aside from like Everest. So in order to create a comprehensive financial planning, we cannot discuss this in details because these are only for securities license, but at least we have a basic overview of what are these vehicles, right? So that when a client or a prospect approach us, we can tell that, does your company, do you also offer like Roth IRA? Because, Roth is very popular because everyone knows about Roth and 401k. At least we can tell that, I don't have a securities license, but we have experts in our team that can help you with that. So in that way, we are, you know, we are able to help them with their need. And at the same time, we can, there is a way for us to get them into the door to introduce the opportunity for them. So first of all is the variable annuity, right? I know that there's been a series of webinars about variable annuities, you know, in our hierarchy. So, you know, variable annuities, it's used for, you know, to maximize return. It can also be for principal protection and lifetime income, right? These are for our clients that are, you know, aggressive, right? So examples of variable annuities are, number one, accumulation annuity. And an example of this is the registered index link annuity. Also for, I just want to make a disclaimer, right? The resources that I have here, I am not recommending them, but these are the companies that I am familiar with. These are the companies that I use. So I can discuss more of them because I have experience with these companies. All right. So for the accumulation annuity, the main concern here is the growth of the investment. Okay. So for accumulation annuity, we have the registered index link annuities, wherein you know, they offer some protection. Some companies offer buffers, which are like 10% or 20%. They can absorb the loss. And they also offer a cap, right? So for example, the Jackson Rila can offer at least like 10 to 20% buffer loss on the loss. And then 6-year segment, they can offer like 250% growth, okay, or cap. So another one is the lifetime income. There are variable annuities that can provide a guaranteed rate of return. For example, you know, the Jackson Perspective, they have like a 6%, you know, guaranteed income or guaranteed growth, I should say, even if the market is down. But if the market is up, then we have, you know, unlimited access to that. So they get the best of both worlds. If the market is down, they can still offer at least like 6%. And if the market is up, they can we can access the growth of the market, right? So what is VUL or Variable Universal Life? These are, this is like an IUL, except that, you know, the money is invested in the stock market. So these are for our market savvy clients that are not contented with the cap of the IULs and can, they are the ones that really wants to invest in the market. And the benefit of this is that they are getting the return tax-free, right? They don't have to pay the capital gains, and at the same time, they're getting still the debt benefit, all right? We also have mutual funds, right, in our companies, and 529s, right? 529s are educational plans, right? Sometimes, you know, the clients, they don't have much time to accumulate the money. So we can also do 529 with them if they have a shorter time. Like they don't have the waiting time that, you know, we need for like IULs and VULs. And it's better for them to have at least some college savings rather than nothing, right? And also we also have some advisory platforms that we, you know, we offer through the Trans Alpha. In these advisory platforms, we have exchange traded funds, you know, for Roth and traditional IRA. TransAlpha is more of a goal-based investing. And it's very, the fee is very not expensive. It's just 0.65 bips, right? So it's a goal-based investing. It can be for a retirement. It can be for education fund. It can also just for be for general investing if the client's goal is for liquidity. And right now, they also, TransAlpha also has a cash reserve. And I usually help clients with this for their emergency fund because, you know, they get, they give 3.2% per year return compared to 0.001 in the bank. And the money is liquid also. You can withdraw anytime, right? So these are like, you know, value-added services that we can provide for our clients. And of course, just make sure if you're able to see this one. For our high net worth clients, we have this Transamerica One Goldman Sachs or Wealth Management. It's active money management for clients that have more than 25,000 and they still want to have their money active, right? This is through the Folio platform for Series 65. By the way, the advisory platforms are for our partners, associates that have Series 65 licenses, right? So the Transamerica One Goldman Sachs, they have defensive strategies when the market is very volatile, and they have offensive strategies when the market is great. All right. And of course, the last one that I want to share is the active money management of 401ks. So what are the current, what is the main problem of employees right now, right? The market is very, very volatile. Everyone's losing in their 401k, 403b, 457. And this is one way that we can help them, active management of 401k, wherein we can connect them to third-party managers like the Pacific Financial Group, wherein, you know, they have experts that manages the money. Same thing with Transamerica, Goldman Sachs, active money management. They have advisors that watches the money 24/7, defensive strategies when the market is down and offensive strategies when the market is up. So I actually have a personal experience with this one. I have a partner and a client in California. She works for Kaiser, and Kaiser allows third-party money managers to get into the employee's plan, 50%. So we're not, the strategy of this is we are not taking the money out because we cannot do that because the 401k is still active. But, you know, we are now comparing the growth of the Kaiser and the brokerage link. So the brokerage link is outperforming the performance of the Kaiser. So she's happy and she's, you know, sharing this to other people. That's why, you know, it's a good thing that it's like a value-added service that we can provide to our clients, that they can share the opportunity. And she also joined our company because we were able to help her with her immediate need of 401k management, all right? So I just want to share this slide. You know, it's from Vanguard. It's a recent study from Vanguard. Wherein there's a hypothetical 500,000 investment that was accumulated for 25 years, right? So this is like, it's just showing the importance of what we do as advisors, right? Because with an advisor, that 500,000, you know, has the potential to grow to 3.4 million after 25 years. Without an advisor, it will only grow up to 1.6 million, right? Usually, you know, these are the self-managed, portfolios. And this applies to everything like 401k, our own investments, right? That's why, you know, it's very important to get the expertise of advisors. Because if hiring an advisor could increase our returns by 1.7 million. All right. So how do I apply this learnings that I have right now? How can I apply it in a more practical term in helping clients? So I just wanted to share this clients that I recently helped in Texas. So I just kind of like darkened the names for privacy. But there's a lot of numbers here, but what I just want you to focus on are like just a quick summary of this one. So these are a couple, both nurses. The wife is 52 years old right now. The husband is 50 years old. Their only goal is to retire in the Philippines at the age of 58 for the wife and 56 for the husband. So they want to go home to the Philippines, and I kind of like revolve the planning around that goal for them to go home to the Philippines. Like, how can I show them that it's possible? How can I help them, right? So these are their current portfolios here. And these are the amounts that—
Charisma, we don't see the spreadsheet.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Let me just make sure. Okay, let me just. How about now, Sunny? Thank you okay. so much for letting me.
Yeah, it's good enough.
All right. Okay. So a lot of numbers here, but I just want to want you to focus on the important parts. So this family, they're both nurses from Texas. These are their current age. Their goal is to retire in the Philippines, go back to the Philippines at the age of 58 and 56. And they said, Charisma, I want you to help us how to plan because that's our goal. So I did the WFGFNA analysis and their projected income need at the age of 58 is 79,000 a year. So that's how I kind of like did my planning, like how can I help them get this amount every year, all right? So these are their current portfolios. They have whole life, they have Allianz, FIA, Roth, they have previous 403B with the previous employer. They also have current 403B retirements. All right. And so these are their current contributions on these portfolios. This is the projection of and the assumptions of our recommendation. So first of all, they have a whole life insurance, right? So it's still in surrender period, so there's nothing we can do about it. But I recommended Nationwide IUL, 300,000 face amount for the husband and wife for their long-term care, which will be max funded for the next 7 years. And the cash value of this IUL can also be a supplement when they retire at 59 to 62, because they by that time they still not be able to pull out any retirement, right? And while waiting for the Social Security. So, and then possible 1035 exchange for the whole life when it's out of surrender period in 2 years. So they also have an Allianz 15,000 FIA from a previous agent. And by the way, the first approach is they just want to roll over. They don't even want to be a part of the team, but they just want to roll over. That was their approach to us. So they have a Roth IRA, husband and wife, right? So I compared the growth of the Roth to the TransAlpha by Vanguard. And year to date, 3 years, 5 years, Vanguard's performing like 2 to 3%. They decided to roll over, right? So they transfer, I should say, their current Roth to TransAlpha Advisory Roth IRA. They have a previous old 403B, 350 for the wife, 250 for the husband. So we rolled over 250 to Jackson and then 100,000 to Allianz for the wife to diversify because they want to take the 35% bonus from Allianz. But they still want 200, she also still want 250 so that, you know, to have access to maximum growth. With Jackson perspective too. Same with the husband, 200,000 to Jackson perspective too, and 50,000 to Allianz. All right, and this is projected to give them 42,000 a year at the age of 65 for the wife and 30,000 for the husband at age 65 combined, FIA and variable. So their current 403B, they have 28 and 21,000. They're putting in 10%. In the 403B, but then after that, you know, I recommended to put 4% just to get the matching and then put the 6% to their Roth 403B for, you know, a tax advantage or tax-free when they retire. So also, since it's not performing well, but they still want to put money in 403B, I recommended brokerage link, active management for defensive strategy during volatility and offensive strategy when the market is up. And to also outperform the benchmark performance, right? They also have money in the bank, 90,000, and they want it liquid. I recommended RILA, but they want something that's liquid. So I recommended cash reserve to get the 3.2% interest rate compared to the 0.001 they're getting in the bank. And I calculated the SSS for them. They want to know at the age of 62 years old, the husband will get this amount, 2,000, 900 per month and 2,700 per month for the wife at the age of 62. So then we were able to get the projected for, because at the age of 58 and 62, when they're going home to the Philippines, they won't still have access to the Jackson and to the SSS and to the Roth. So the cash reserve will sustain them 62 to 64, 58 to 62. If it's like 80,000 a year, they would need 320,000. They can get that from the cash reserve. And then 62 to 64, they can use the Social Security, which is going to be like 68,000 a year, and get 30,000 for cash reserve, right? And then, of course, they still have additional retirement supplement as needed from the IUL cash value and from, because they have a house here in the US and they're still planning to sell that. And at the age of 65, they will have 140,000 projected, because they will have 72,000 from Jackson and Allianz and 68,000 a year from Social Security. So she was so happy that we were able to at least project that they can retire to the Philippines. So she was happy. She became a partner. And now she's recruiting. She recommended this to her friends. And her structure now is like an MD structure, but she doesn't have a license yet. So she has to work on the license. And on our part, our team was able to close 12 applications with this couple. Two variable annuities, two fixed index annuities, two IULs, two Roth IRA transfers, and the four 403B and Roth active money management. So that's 12 applications in one family. So that's all I can share. And, you know, I just encourage everyone to keep on helping families, because what we do is very precious, you know. What we do is very important, because, you know, we always go back to our mission of no family left behind, because financial security is not a dream, but a priority. Thank you so much, Team Everest, for this opportunity to share with you tonight.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, Charisma, for that wonderful sharing. I've learned a lot. I was some kind of technique around here, but I've made some notes. Hopefully all of you have learned something new today. Our next speaker, I'm really delighted. I'm humbled and honored to welcome our next speaker, who's going to talk about the business. This none other than a person I know very well now. I used just to hear her 2 years ago before I joined the business, but I met her more than four times. Humble, knowledgeable, and a team player. She doesn't mince words. She means what she says. She's all I can talk to about to anybody. Now, welcome me, please, all of you help me welcome our EVC, Executive Vice Chair, 1 million ring Anna, Ling Ling.
Thank you, Dad. How are you? Good evening, everyone. Good evening, Team Everest. It's good again. Every Monday, we get a chance to see each other, see all the beautiful smiles here, all the learning hearts here. Charisma, you wow me. Right? I still remember meeting you for the first time, and I cannot imagine from a medical background today, right? She can do such a comprehensive financial planning. You shocked me. Right? It's like that really shows how we can have the ability to learn. I think everybody in this business, when you come in, if you say, oh, Ling, I don't know any finance, I don't know anything about numbers, but see, Charisma today, she can help families like such comprehensively, even more than me, Charisma. So I'm humble. I'm really amazed at the transformational process of WFG. So whatever you want to learn, you can actually learn it here. So super job, Charisma. Keep it up. Congratulations on the 100K ring. And my next challenge for you, of course, hopefully you can learn from the next speaker, Sonia, because she just got promoted to be Sonia here. Everybody say hi. Okay, we're going to have an interview session for for today. It's really my privilege to interview her, actually. Actually, for those of you who don't know, Sonia is actually our team pride and our pride from our village, we said it, right? For those of you who don't know, she and I share the same background in China. We came from the same villages in China, like literally the same hometown called Taishan, China. All the families come to America and do restaurant business. That's where we come from. So that's why Sonia always, ever since before when I first started the business, people always say, Ling, right? People from our hometown, we don't have big dreams. We don't have big goals. And we just want a comfortable life. And only you can do it. I cannot do it, right? So today I'm so glad Sonia is here sharing the stage with me. And she's the newest and the youngest $250,000 ring earner. She's born in after the 1990s. Every single time I think about it, I'm so jealous. I was like, I wish I'm 10 years younger like her. And if she can show you she's so young, she can do it, right? And she has a beautiful family. Even though she's young, don't get fooled by her. She already have two beautiful kids, Paris and Philip, and one each year, okay? She's very productive, not only in the business, but also in the family, right? And what I remember most about Sonia is when I first know her a few years ago, when we come back to the business, and I saw her, she was pregnant, right? Her belly is really huge, like all the way up here. And I said, this young girl, right? She's like so young and she's already pregnant. And then her belly's eight months pregnant. And so I said, what are you doing here? This is in Vegas convention. And she fly over there and train. And then, you know, when you're pregnant, you're kind of tired. And then we saw pictures of her just like taking a short nap, short dose, and then go back to training, right? So what kind of person, what kind of learning heart do we have for someone like that? That's why now I know success leaves trails. And today we're really happy and I'm really honored to have her to share her story with us. And then afterwards I'll ask her some questions so that you guys can pick her brain. And how many of you, let me see a raise my hands, right? How many of you want to be $250,000 ring, right? And not only $250,000 ring, she got her 100K to $250,000 in 6 months. 6 months, guys. So that really is very, very amazing. So please help me welcome Sonia. Can you please quickly share with us your story? How did you start in WFG?
Thank you so much, Elaine, for your wonderful introduction. You know, actually, my plan was like, you know, 8 months pregnant, I could have given birth on the airplane. And I actually chose Southwest. That's my favorite airline. I was planning if I happen to born, like, you know, giving birth in the airplane, then I get I heard that they can give like a lifetime. You can fly with them for free. Okay, so yeah, that's great. I mean, I do appreciate it with Ling. Always, like, you know, she given me the role model, and I know that people from a small village can also make it. That is actually the success proven. And my background is actually very simple. You know, I come into America as a new immigrant. And I started the business second year after I landed to America, fresh off the boat, not even speaking good English. But I actually took the opportunity because I want to learn English and I want to get to know America better, right? That is my very first year in America. And I took my license, I passed it. So I'm actually very fortunate. But anyhow, I was so new, you know, not even knowing how to use the laptop and all that. And I'm still in a languages class. And then actually I didn't do the business so well. So I quit after a year in the business. I actually off to, you know, because I already get licensed, right? And I go to do health insurance. And then also in the traditional agent. After a couple of years, you know, I actually be approached in this business again. That's like so many people share with me this opportunity. Okay, then let me take a second look. So actually, Judy and Tommy find me from the second-hand market. How many of you not the first time heard about WFG? That is me. So, but after a couple of years, my market has become a little bit better, and now the rest of the history. So I actually get started, become an MD the first year, and 50K part-time income the first year. And then a couple more years later, and I become a, you know, SMD and 100K and all that. So thank you, Ling.
All right. Secondhand market. Interesting. My first time hearing that. Okay. So actually, you guys know, right? Whether or not we're first time, second time,
third time in this business, I think for those people who actually come back to the business, there must be something special about the business that continue to attract them. I think that's why, Sonny, I'm sure deep down you appreciate it about WFG. So especially working a few years in the traditional industry, can you tell us a little bit, what did you observe, the difference, the biggest difference between traditional agent and WFG system?
You know what, actually it's a lot difference. People outside the industry may think, oh, it's all about insurance. But inside the industry, we all know there is actually so many little things are different. First of all, I would say, you know, if in the traditional agent, my previous agency only care about my numbers of production every single month. I know they give me quotas and I have to meet them every single month. And if not, if I don't produce in a full month, they have kicked me out of the system. So actually we do have quotas, right? And I know the moment I start working, I don't have income anymore because it's all based on the personal production. I have a team, right? My team is me, myself, and I. So, you know, in this business, you know, we all have teamwork. I remember when I first started a business and Judy was helping me hand on hand and, you know, and always giving me the second opinions when I see, you know, go see client. I come back to Judy. I said, like, Judy, is there any better way I can do? Can you, I can tell you the process and anywhere I can improve. So I'd be able to, you know, I have a mentor and I finally found that, you know, I feel like I am being homeless before and now I have a parent. So that happiness that I actually found in this business. And also the teamwork. Yeah, I remember when I started business first year, I've never been to, someone reached out to me from Pennsylvania. God, I didn't know where Pennsylvania in the US map. So I never been to Pennsylvania before. And yeah, so it happened that the prospect is from Pennsylvania. And I asked Judy, I'm not planning to fly there. What do I do, right? Judy actually helped me to reach out to one of the local big leader, you know, Joanne Shu. So she actually not only helping that client, but also that client become an agent of us and pass license. Not only that, she bring her neighbor also take license and start building a team. I was like, what? This would never happen in my traditional business. So it was like pretty amazing. Yeah.
Wow. So Sonia is
very- And then one thing I want to add. I'm sorry, Link. I'm so excited. One thing that I, you know, my previous agency with my previous you know, the traditional agent, they never asked me to read books. Why here? I remember Sonny, Link, and Judy. Everybody asked me, you should read this book, Sonia. You could continue to do self-study. That is actually amazing. You guys are really care about my improvement, become a better person. Yeah. So I feel like a family here.
I can see your English is very good now. Definitely a big transformation. And of course, I do think not only traditional agents, I think most people, because we have like an employee mindset coming in here, building is the biggest, like I would say, the obstacle for a lot of people, especially a lot of sales agents, like real estate agent or any other agent coming to the system. They always say, oh, sales is so easy, but building people is so hard. So what was the biggest transition for you? How did you overcome that mental block? And how did you start learning to build a team here, Sonia?
You know, coming from a traditional agent background, right? Selling is not hard for me at all because, you know, I already admitted myself as an insurance agent, right? When people ask me, what do you do? I feel so comfortable telling them I do insurance, right? I can help you with insurance needs. So with that, you know, I actually can, production is never a problem for me, but transition from building, it's something different. You know, it is challenging in the beginning because I don't have that experience, right? Raising someone, like being a parent, raising a kid, no experience, we all have to learn, right? But the good thing is we can learn along the way. I think that, you know, it's until you find the right leader. I remember one day, you know, after a couple of years in the business, right? And I always telling myself, oh, building is not easy. Until one day, you know, actually Nina and Julia joined the business after New Year kickoff, right? And one day they called me up, Sonia, you know, maybe sometime you can be in Houston and help us to build a team. I said, like, what happened? And Julia told me, you know, we both get an individual office for our own. We are ready to run for business. I was like, you guys only started business. This is the second month, right? So until you find the right leaders, everything is ready. Mm-hmm. So, I one thing I did good, I think I, you know, stay persistent because mm-hmm. I never stopped, you know, sharing the opportunity to others. even though, you know, there are some challenges I have, especially in 2018, the very first year I started a business, right? And I have, I remember this consistent month, 2 months along the way, I do 5, 5:30. So there's 10 new people, 10 new partners join the business, but actually none of them actually work out. So I was wondering why people don't stay in the business so good, right? And how come people, you know, don't see it, the vision that I see? And I even travel to California to build the new partners over there. But I think that I'm so proud that I didn't stop believing the power of team building and team compounding, because only that, and I consistent sharing the opportunity. Therefore, one day Nina actually come join the business and then also follow it with the rest of the team. Yeah. And then I think one more thing is, it's not about the building is hard. Sometimes we think that, oh, you know, building is hard, this business didn't work out. It's not about this business. I'm telling you, we are fighting against people's human nature. Because, you know, many people, they are built. I mean, they actually growing up and being an employee, they try to be an employee, school trained employees, right? And, you know, just like in the airplane, when the airplane take off, they get used to, you know, just lay back and, you know, snore. Not one day you can tell them that you can be a captain. They feel scared. People think they're scared. They never been an entrepreneur before. And so therefore, I think that fighting against human nature, it is difficult. So it's not about this business. So I think that, you know, building is not easy, but it's totally worth it. I have all the patience to do it the rest of my life. So.
Wow. Very good. I love to hear that, especially when I see you can start to learn building. I think I'm sure Sunny and I feel the happiest, right? And Judy. And of course, you already say that, okay, you don't mind to say in trends, right? But for many of us, we're not comfortable, right? Of, like, especially me, like when I first started, I was so worried that people say, Lane, you're a CPA and now you're selling insurance. I did not have that closing mindset. I did not have that comfort zone to talk about insurance. So how come you have such a strong belief in insurance, and where do your closing mentality come from? How can you close so much cases? To how many cases did you close, have that kind of confidence now to, and get your $250,000, right? We wanted to know the details. What is your work ethic? What's your time management?
Until now, you actually asked me. So I think that from August until now, so literally like about 4 months, I help not only me and my team, right? With the team, you know, team production. I think we help total about close to 40 families, 37 in 4 months. Wow. I didn't actually born as, you know, good at closing. But because of, you know, in the beginning, I remember in my beginning of my career, right? My friend actually asked me, you know, can you help me with the, you know, financial planning, insurance, right, protection? I asked them why, right? And he is actually a very good friend of mine. I know him since the year one when I landed to Chicago. And we work in the same place. And actually his dad passed away. And after that, he said, oh, you got license for insurance? Perfect, right? Can you help me to set up some plan for me and my mom? So actually, that is my very first group of clients. I do appreciate it. And I helped them to fill out the application. That wasn't easy, right? But I actually, when I delivered the case approved, right? Delivered the case to the family. So his mom tell me, you know what? My age is older. You know, why don't you get for my son first? I can wait, right? Mine is like about triple of what my son pays. So, you know, his dad already passed away. I want something for him. And we better just fund his policy first. Mine can wait. So it's impossible that something happened to my family again, like big number logic, right? But unfortunately, you know what? His mom didn't take the policy. I was so shy, right? You know, I feel like I can't just force them to get a policy for my own. I feel so bad. I was so like, you know, I just get licensed, right? Not so mature. And I doubt that they will say, oh, you know, Sonia earned my money and all that, right? So a lot of small bosses. So I just walked away from them and then just, you know, delivered the case for my friend, not for his mom. But you know what? 6 months later, his mom diagnosed with cancer. True story. So that become my pain. That become my pain. Sometimes I wake up the middle of the night, I cry, right? So he actually, his mom passed away a couple years ago, after like about 3 years struggle with fighting against cancer, I see the whole process, the whole thing, how the families survive. And my friend, his wife left him because the families are deeply in financial debt. He is my age, and he have to afford for his younger little sister. That time it was only 12 years old. And he's been, you know, paying for both funerals for his dad and his mom. And I see that he's like, you know, working three jobs and trying to survive as a young man. So, and it's hard. So I know his family is deeply in financial debt. So I'm thinking that I could have, you know, pushed a little bit and let his mom to take the policy. Maybe if there's only a $2,000 or $3,000 that she pays, but she gets $300,000 of the death benefit payout, that could completely change the financial future of him. So until today, 6 years later, this family still not pay off the debt yet. So I actually, God gave me a chance to help them, but I didn't take it. So now I see that a lot of the family are deeply drawn in water. So I need to help out these families. I believe closing is helping. We educate them and didn't do anything, walk out from the family. We didn't help them until we killed them to do something, right? And I think the follow-up is important. So few people that we talked to in the past, it average take them like about, 5 to 7 times of the follow-up to make something happen, right? But usually it actually, some of the families, it only help, take like a 2 or 3 times to help you to close, help them to do something, do financial planning, set up properly financial protection, right? So I believe closing is helping. So I have no shame to talk about anything about insurance. People need insurance anyhow, right?
Yes. I think that is actually the biggest secret. If anyone asks, oh, what is Sonia's secret? I really think it's her belief. It's her strong belief, and she's had no shame. And she said, you know what? You can put my own time. She was sharing in Chinese training and crack everybody up. She said, what is the value of my face? I can put it down. I can step on it a couple of times. It's okay, right? I think that's kind of down-to-earth mentality, and you want to go out there and help families truly transform your entire business right now. So I'm so happy for you. At the same time, I still remember, Sonia, when I first challenged you a couple years ago, I always say, why is this girl always telling me, Ling, all I want to make is just 50,000, right? Back then when she first came in, I remember like your dream was not that big, right? So can you share with us a little bit now, your whole journey now from 50K watch, 100K ring, and then $250,000 on the ring. What has your value changed on money, or on the perspective of money, or your dream size? Can you tell us a little bit, how did you grow your dream in this business?
Yeah, you know what? I think lucky enough, I met a lot of individuals in the business that they saying that, you know, oh, I never growing up, my life is so smooth. I never have to worry about money. So therefore I don't have a big buy, right? I get that a lot in the business. Like, and then I also, you know, so, but I think back that when I growing up, you know, I think money is important for me, right? The money value actually is from my small, when I growing up, a lot of small moments from my life. Mm-hmm. I remember when I was like about in the middle school, right? About 13 or 12 years old. And, one day I actually cannot see the blackboard. I know that I get nearsighted, right? Cause I see a lot of classmates start wearing the glasses. I mentioned to my mom, you know, it's time for me to get glasses. I cannot see the blackboard, right? My mom said, I know my family background. They're trying to survive, right? And my dad and my mom working really hard and trying to pay our tuitions. And we come from a small village, and it's not easy to, you know, to pay off the tuition all one time. And that is pretty normal to me. And my mom said, I cannot, maybe we can wait, another couple months to get you a glasses. We cannot really afford it right now. So, but I mean, until like about a year later, I actually finally wear glasses, but actually my test score is actually become really low because I barely catching up about my academy, right? So it's just like really difficult. Growing up, I found out that many of my classmates, they actually have textbooks. they have a practice books, and they can help them, to help after school, and they can still practicing by their own. And they actually, when teacher asks us to do, to do some homework, and they can be able to research on the computer, and, they dance things so fast, they talk a lot of words that I never heard. So as a little girl, I was thinking that, it's not about like a people in my village that people walking without shoes, right? And they actually have computer like that. And we don't have computer at home. We don't have practice books, right? And I know that, that is about all about the money. If we have a little bit more money that we can be able to afford it, maybe that can help support me to learn better, to get a better score, or maybe, get more resources outside of school. And, that could, along the way, that could change. And I don't want that to happen to my kids. So I think that it's very important. And then money can bring the freedom of choice. And, we in America, right, we are in a land of the free, but actually we didn't take fully advantage of it. So since we are here, I don't want to just survive being average. Even though my mom tells me, being a young lady, right, a female, you don't have to work really hard. You just need to marry someone and be comfortable. I don't know. I'm growing up, all my people around me telling me that I thought that is true, but after I talked to so many people, and I feel like they might be have another lifestyle I can be able to live in America, since we're already in the land of the free. And I don't want any money to limitate my kids' future. I want them to get the best education and they can achieve their dream, right? So money is important. I actually admitted in the beginning. And I thought that the 50K is actually, I can make it a full-time job and I can be able to, survive in a business, just make it as a job for me. And I'm comfortable. But actually at the end, I found out there's so much more I can be able to do in this business. After I see some in the convention, I see people making like 2 million, 3 million, 1 million. I said like, maybe one day I can be able to be a little bit bigger, right? So actually, I really happy that, this business and also the leader's vision that can stretch my vision, and I can be able to see my blowing in the convention and learn from event from event.
Yes, yes, yes. So I think, especially every time I see you, I think the learning attitude, right? For those of you who don't know, I think Sonia, even though she always tell me, Ling, I don't have university background, right? I cannot even do the computer back then, but your learning ability is very quick. You can learn English, you can learn Excel now. I can see you doing Excel, doing computer, everything. And you say you never have university. So tell us a little bit, how do you improve on learning? How do you do that from someone, even though they didn't have the background right now, instead of seeing all the PhDs in the team, and then they would say, PhD can do it. I don't identify. I don't feel belong here. How did you make yourself belong in this learning environment, Sonia?
You know what? I actually have a little bit of confidence. I feel like I belong here from the beginning. I mean, I actually, different way of thinking. I actually is sitting in the room, and I remember my very first convention when Rocky ask us, how many of you that you have a, education of MBA and above? Like, wow, a big group stand up. And I was like, my God, I'm in the right place. Why? I think like these people are so smart. They are actually so highly educated. They actually are so, such big leader. I am sharing the same platform like them. I have no big difference like them. They're doing the same thing. I can do this. If they share with me their secret, which is this business, I could learn from them directly, right? Mm-hmm. So, one in the world is a passive learning, which is maybe, all my parents tell me to go to university, so I have to go like 4 years. But while the active learning, I love the active learning. Learn something I could use, learn something that is useful for me, and never stop learning to be a better person. So I am active learning in the field. For 10 years of experience, that is more than an MBA's degree in the field, right? So just without a paper. So I am totally feel like I'm in the right place. But in the beginning, definitely it's not easy. I remember start a business. I was taking a license with Lily Huang, right? So Lily Huang, I see she's in the line today. One day in the training, the speaker was talking, Let's read this statement, right, guys? Let's take a look at here. And I was asking, I was elbowing Lily. Lily, what is called a statement? You know, see, back then I even don't know what statement is called. So my English was so bad, right? But I'd be able to learn along the way and, you know, just keep improving. And, you know, before the business, I don't even know how to use a laptop properly. Because, you know, before I immigrated over, I actually didn't have a laptop at home. Like I went to the places with the computer. I actually learned a little bit, but not a lot how to use the laptop properly. I also make a lot of mistakes. Don't get me wrong. From the day one, you're picking up so fast. No, I make a lot of mistakes. I remember I was following up case because my communication is not so well. I couldn't understand what the case manager asked me to do. I yell at the case manager. So I actually make a lot of mistakes. So miscommunication end up that case that get declined. So I learn from the mistakes, you know. But fortunate that we get so many chance. We can every day we can start from zero again and learn from the mistake day by day. And I you know, just keep improving. Once if we keep improving, we keep climbing up, even though we at the bottom of the mountain, one day you can be at the top if you don't stop, right? You keep climbing and keep improving yourself. So and then also I want to bring the value, the family's values to my kids of not being comfortable. I want them to be somebody great, from good to great, not just shadow here as being average, right? I want the value of excellence for happen to my kids. And I want to, you know, give them an example of success. So all my team as well, I think that I want to set an example for you guys. Even people like me can do it. You guys can definitely can do it. Yeah. And then also I think that the convention is also a very good place to learn. Convention is what I call WSG University, because we can learn everything from the convention. Only happen twice a year, right? Cannot afford to miss it. I think convention it saved me a lot of time. It clear out my doubt. From the beginning, I never doubted I couldn't do this business. From after the convention, you know, I coming back, I only have one thing in my mind. How can I do this? Instead of I sitting there and observe other people can success, and then I make a decision to be success. From the beginning, I actually believe it. I can make it in this business. How? Judy, I actually yell really hard. Like, you know, I'm the one growing up. I'm actually the second child of my family, right? Being a second child, I think that it's I know the how to pleasure my parents, right? I'm the one who is always hungry and crying, like, you know, I need more milk, right? I need to get more attention. I actually grabbed attention from Judy in the beginning. Judy, how can I do this? I couldn't understand this from the training. Can you explain to me again, right? Can I make a time with you? I actually yell really hard. That's how I learned.
So that's a big tip, everybody, right? You gotta better grab onto your trainer and get their time, right? So I'm sure Judy feels that you love to learn. Your desire to learn is good. That's why she dedicates so much time. And actually now a lot of people are saying, like, Sonny, I know your husband works very hard as well. He has his own salon, right? He owns his own salon, hair specialist. He's very busy. And you have to take the kids to school. You have to take the kids home. You have to get them into activities and still can make $250,000 work it here. And you still can have you still work in health insurance, I know too, right? So you have like two jobs, two business, and you still have two kids. And then your parents, of course, helping. How do you do time management good? And can you share with us one quick tip on time management?
I think the time management is we have to do things efficient. Because many, you know, sometimes I heard excuses like that. Oh, because I have kids, that's why I cannot make it, right? I have kids, I have to take care of the kids first. There is you know, it feels like it's easy way out for them. I didn't make it because of my kids, right? But I don't want to take my kid as excuse, you know, because time is always, if you stress your time, you always can make something happen. You have time to eat, right? You have time to rest, right? That means we could have time to do some stuff. And because of I get to pick up my kids every day at 11, right? When I sit in front of my computer at 9:00, 9:30, I know that I have to make this call right now. I don't, right? I actually see some, you know, of the new trainees, they're holding the phone for 1 hour. They're trying to make a call out to that prospect. And then they're holding the phone. It's like a ton's head, like a heavy, right? They cannot even dial the phone number out. They already start thinking that, imagine if my friends say no to me, what do I do, right? I have no time to think. I have to dial that call right now. I have to call because I got to pick up my kids later. If I don't dial right now, I don't have time to make this call right now, today, right? So I actually don't wait. Do things efficient and also to, you know, and then, you know, just being like a goal oriented. I always set a goal for myself every single month, and I break down every single week. What should I need to do? What should I need to accomplish? And then break down the goals for every day. Like I break out my day in 3 mini day, the morning, afternoon, and evening. If I prioritize my kids' activity in the morning, and then at afternoon and evening time, I can make some activities. So I plan my day ahead, like for the whole week, right? And then deeply, I actually believe that if we know our why, we will know our how. If our why are big enough, we were going to know how to do it. If it is not, maybe you just being comfortable, right? So we should just ask ourselves, do you really want this? If you want it, then just go ahead and, you know, make progress. If you need help to do it, just reach out your SMD.
Yes, yes, yes. Of course, right? Because she reached out also because she's the biggest flag carrier. I know that you always carry the flag for Judy, right? About her CEO run. You always carry flag for Team Everest. So, you know, it's two-way street. It's not just one way. You're not just crying for the SMB, right? But can you tell us a little bit about why you want to carry a flag for the team? And then so you can share with us one tip, like right now to be a $250,000 winner, should be focused on this business. And we can wrap up.
So now you guys know my background. I come from like basically under the ground, not from the ground, right? So I actually learned so much from Judy, Ling, and Shani, and all of you. You know, our team, I love our team environment, which is all of you here, create an environment here. It take a whole, one thing Ling always say, it take a whole village to raise a child. I completely agree with that. And I learned so much from you guys in the beginning, especially Judy. Judy is the person who I work very closely since day one. And she helped me hand in hand and, you know, with all, she almost like, I introduced her all my connection. I want her to help me in the beginning because some people I talked to them, it didn't work out. It would be really great if someone can help me to, you know, to reach out to those market again and help out from the beginning. And I just cannot thank enough somebody like Judy, and also Ling, like, you know, give me continually of the leadership growth and Sunny and all of the team here. So I want to give him back. I know that, Judy is, I see like how Michelle and Kim and Victor, Jenny, Beatrice, you guys are doing so good in the business. So I can't just let, I want to see Judy also being in the stage. Mm. So Judy and Kai, like, I can't wait you guys to be a 1 million. Yes. So Judy is so nice, so patient. I mean, if you're not on the stage, then who will, right? So I will do whatever it takes to carry the flag for Judy and Kai. Especially now we in the Team Everest. I know Sunny and then Ken are running for the 2 million right now. Mm-hmm. So doing my best part, it will help out the whole team. So it's a win-win condition. So we can't wait to see you guys to make it 2 million this month. So I'm actually continue to making progress. Even though I'm coming back from Houston, Texas, this trip, I didn't fully recover from the cough, right? But I'm still making things happen. Help out 5 families this week, right? So and continue to ask the team to support and giving us all. So we are all together. It's not about me. It's not about, you know, this small team. It's about the big team.
Definitely. So, because of time, I know we can have a lot more to learn from you in Vegas, not Vegas, Houston Convention. Share with us right now, what is your dream right now, Sonia? One last question. What is your goal? What is your goal now that you're $250,000? What is your next dream? Tell us your dream.
I think that, after the surviving stage, right, what I call surviving stage, I actually been blessed. People who share with me, Tommy, share with me this opportunity.
Right.
So that I can change my life completely, change my lifestyle as well. I want to give in this blessing for more families out there.
Yes.
And also I want to, you know, give in a better way for people who just work as employee, they do just enough so that, you know, the boss didn't fire them. And they actually, you know, the boss just paid them enough, just, you know, so that people don't leave their job and continue working for them as a slave. So I want to changing people to be a better life and giving out this opportunity, right? Recruiting and giving out opportunity is a blessing, right? It's a gift. So, yes. And I want to everybody, you know, in my team, right, become SMD. And I want one day I have big leaders in all different states. So we plan a thread in all 50 states to build a business big. And, you know, so Team Everest, we can be able to, you know, have more than 300 of the millionaires in a couple years. So
you
we have
increase
a big goal.
Our goal. You increase our goal from 100 to 300. Thank you, Sonia. Okay. All right. Lastly, thank you, Sonia. Your story is very inspiring. In the beginning, she's always worrying, my English is not good. Can I speak Chinese? But today she did a fantastic job. Let's give her a big hand. I'm going to very quickly close. I just want to show you guys some very treasured pictures. This is Sonia. This is where she grew up from. This is her village, right? That's why it reminds me of my village. That's where I grew up from. If you look at her, do you believe one day she can be in America making $250,000 a year and one day millionaire and multiple millions in the future, right? That's her. That's the hometown. So you're going to be proud of our Taishan. You know, all of our people come from our area. And then when she first came to America, she said, fresh off the boat, right? If you look at that picture, two innocent girls, Lily and Sonia, together they're joining this business, but there's, look at that. Can you identify with that? Can you see someone else out there like them? Can you see them? And can you see one day she can transform into the person she is today? And now she can be, look how beautiful she is. She look very poised, very professional, and she can help people and really help people bring solutions to them. So that's a very inspirational story. And I hope that can you also dream it possible, right? Can you also dream it possible? So last, I have a few sentences. I think she always tell me, Ling, I'm an ordinary girl. I really think Sonia, she may be an ordinary girl, but she has an extraordinary work ethic. She may be have an ordinary upbringing, but she has an extraordinary dream. And most importantly, she may have ordinary parents, like she told me a couple of times. But I think because of this business, she now has an extraordinary environment to learn and grow. And not only that, right? Her story, Sonia's story may show us now, it's not one's background. I love it. She's like under the ground. It's not one's background that matters. It's the transformation process that determines who we become, and we are witnessing who you are becoming, and we're so proud of that. And life is not defined by our circumstance. You may not speak English, you may not know computer, you may not have friends, any circumstance, but you know what? Life is defined by our will to win and our will to fight against all the odds. And she did, and this is only the beginning. So looking back, I know you have come a long way, Sonia, from zero to $250,000, but this new milestone is only the foundation for much greater success ahead. And everyone, I just wanna close. I wanna ask you guys, today we heard Sonia's story. But what is your dream? What are you willing to fight for? So can you please write your story? Can every one of us continue to write our story? And one day we look forward to your sharing. All right, thank you. I will pass it back to our MC Dan. Thank you. Thank you, Sonia. Thank you everybody for hearing our story.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, Sonia. That's a very encouraging message to all of us. If you have ears, you have heard. There's no obstacle, the sky's the limit. I picked out some of the lessons, persistency, consistency, building the team is not easy. You fight, or believe in what you're doing, set a goal for yourself. Those are some of the key points I've learned. I've written them down myself. I hope everyone has been writing down some very important points for us to grow in this business. It doesn't matter your background. It doesn't matter where you come from. It doesn't matter your color. We can all get there, and we will get there. So just as announcement for today, let me share my screen and do the announcement. Good. I'm really privileged to do this announcement because thanks, Sunny, for giving me this opportunity. At a very good opportune time, 3 years ago, 2019, it was such a time that I joined this business, November 2019. 2 months after that, there was a convention, just like Sonia said, two conventions in the year, one at the beginning of the year and one at summertime. When Victor and Jenny presented to me, I was excited. And so I believed, because Beatrice, I knew who Beatrice was way before. I knew she's not gonna introduce me to an entity that will tank my life. But then, if you want to erase your skepticism, like the community where I come from, and most of you who come from where I come from in Africa, we're very skeptical. So when Victor presented this 2 months after I joined, I not made money. I paid my own air ticket. There was a convention coming up. I went to Maryland, 2020 February, before the world closed down because of COVID. Luckily enough, thanks to God, that convention took place, and it took up. When I came from there, that was it up to date. What I learned, what I got from there, by just learning from successful businessmen and women on this platform and founders of this business, made me who I am up to date. In 3 years in the business, I can see where it's getting me. So it arrests any skepticism. So if you are skeptical, if you are dealing with a community that sits on the fence, this is the time for you. Again, we have an opportunity to come. We are going for the new year kickoff in January. 2 year kickoffs. In fact, Team Everest is a big team now. It has two different, we're going to have two different new year kickoffs in Texas. I think something's happening in Texas where I am right now, right? Everything is happening in Texas. So next year, January, the same weekend, we'll be in Houston. At the same time, Star will be having also a convention in Austin. One is the capital city of Texas. Another one is a major city in the United States, the fourth largest city in the United States. So if you have not bought your ticket, if you are here and you have not signed up for this convention, very important, take it. It took me, when I went to it, that is it. It changed my mindset, and up today I'm here the way I say. In Houston, don't miss it. And you know what, in Houston, that's why I've fought so hard to make sure that in my team, I have now five MDs. I know they'll come, all of them, to this event. If you are an MD and above, you learn a lot from, you're gonna meet the man I saw for the first time in my life and has really left me. I speak about him all the time, Raja Dhaman. The first time I saw him was in Maryland. Don't fail to come and listen to a founder of this company, Rich Tolley, very important. And of course, Dr. Wang Yang, executive chair. You learn a lot. If you have not booked your air ticket, book it. If you have not registered, register for it, right? And the good thing is, those who are, even if you are inviting new people, new associates who are coming in, they are still entitled to come and be part of us, attend the convention at the discounted rate that we had 2 months or 3 months ago. So when you sign up, when you get your new associates, sign them up for the new year kickoff. And I'm so glad it's coming. You know what time is happening? Those of you who have kids, it's gonna be a holiday weekend, St. Martin Luther King weekend. Come along and get to learn a lot that weekend. It's fun in Texas, in Houston, in Austin. It's not as cold as some of where you are. It's like a springtime here. So you'll really enjoy the weather and learn a lot from the new year kickoff. So I encourage all of you to come and learn and come and listen with your own ears and your own face. Hey, you'll not go wrong. Physical attachment is more better than even you add on what you see on Zooms. It's gonna make a lot of impact, and you'll come out of this, your business will just grow by itself. You become who you believe you're gonna be. And if you believe you can be here and attend the convention, it's gonna change your business. It's gonna make it better than where it is right now. So with those few remarks, I think I'm gonna hand over the closing to Johnny. Is Johnny here?
I'm here. Hey, Dan.
Johnny. Oh, I was looking for you. Johnny, please come and close for us now for the day.
Okay. Let's run a quick recognition before. Johnny?
Yep.
Yes, let's do a quick, like a few minutes recognition for the top performers of last month before we close today's meeting by Johnny. So everybody, can you stay till the end, please, right?
All right. Is that awesome? In a one single month, the team members have a such great performance, and all those congratulations to all the performers. You see, we have the promotions, the income milestone, the rings, right? And the license, the net license, and also all those, behind that, there's so many family get help. So many lives got touched, right? How many of you want to be on the recognition board next time? And how many of you think about that? How many of you want to have your team members on that recognition board, right? Be the king, be the kingmakers. That's the goal of this business. That's all the business about. Okay, great. I'm so honored to be the closing speaker for today's training. Every month we have this supercharged Monday. All right. Yeah. Here I am. Here, 1 second. Okay, good. All right. So, for the speakers, we all talk about the conventions, right? The NYKO is closing up next month, right? I want to show everybody one photo. Okay, that's back in 2007, right? We didn't call NYKO at the time. That's in May though. But this is basically the size of Team Everest. It's a team of young professionals we're basically immigrants and who has a goals and dreams and wanted to achieve something together. Do you see Sunny and Ken? Do you see Ling? Ling, you just like, you get younger and younger. I don't know why. You see myself over there? I think we'll have Hongmei and Leon and all right, that's the team. And you know what? That's just a group of young professionals, right? But look at the team average today. You know, the NYKO earlier this year, this is our team. Okay. Now we are a multicultural company with more than 1,400 plus licensed associates. Actually come from, I think, 50 different countries, right? Yeah, from all walks of life, different background. And I'm glad I'm one of them, and I witnessed the growth of Team Everest in the last more than a decade. So in the next 10, 20, 30 years, will you be the witness of this team growing to be a giant in the financial industry, right? So I will be there. And more importantly, at the same time, you yourself will grow to be a better version of yourself, right? So, and the future you will be so proud of your decision today. So that's so important, right? It's the decision we make 15 years ago that we lead to the team today. And we're gonna get bigger and bigger and stronger 20, 30 years later, right? So, and I want to tell you, the number one decision, okay, you should make in this business is not to get licensed. It's not you even become a client. I would say it is going to the NYKO big event, okay? If you are the first time, if this is your first time, you're just new, brand new, and the first big events, I encourage you to be there. You got to know the real Team Everest, who we are, what we do as a team, as a company. And you're gonna learn a lot of stuff over there, have a good discussions over there, right? Especially in this post-pandemic era, we gotta talk to each other face-to-face, and that's the way that how we learn, and the environment itself will make you grow, okay? We recognize, we praise people, recognize people, give them reward. Maybe this is the first time you're not on the stage, but through your clapping, you're gonna feel the joy over there, and you wanna be there. You wanna feel the belongings, right? Of course, we have dinners and team gatherings. We have a gala night with raffles, and we have smaller group discussions. We have like a culture night, right? And we have some energy over there. We also have the cool, calm, that kind of a thinking moment. Right? That will help you become a better version of yourself. We're gonna have some fun together, right? We're gonna have a gala night, right? Dress up, and we have some interviews to the kids. This time we have some, we want the whole family, really make it a family business. And for a lot of associates here, including myself, you know, my why is the business, is Ethan, is my son, is my family. I want to bring a better future for them, right? And this is a true family business. We already have a lot of kids registered, right? And I know there are some younger kids, the parents gonna bring them there, just like the photo, this photo right there, right? So I highly encourage you, no matter how many times be there, you don't wanna miss this life-changing event. It changed my life. I'm so proud to say from 2007 to today, I never miss a big event in a single year. Okay? I understand, I believe that the thinking breakthrough, you know, the only one can hold you back is yourself. The thinking breakthrough happens in the big event. And to me, that's a shortcut. Okay, so do the smart way. All right, so convention, I highly, highly recommend. Okay, and let's recap quickly on our simple, duplicatable startup system. I know for a lot of you, you are new to the business. We have about 250 people online today. Okay, thank you for being online because you want to change your life. You want to change your family's life. You want to learn something, right, today. Okay, so we have a joint owned license, net license system, very simple. Right. So the first thing is join. No matter what is join, this belongs to you. You belong to us. Okay. No matter the weekly trainings, like today, right? The monthly Elite Circle, we just finished the 2022. You know, I'm so eager to, pump up for the 2023 right after NYKO, right? Yeah. One of our associates who joined the Elite Circle, this is the first time, and she said, "Hey, Johnny, I get this, I get that. Can I qualify the Elite Circle? Can I qualify the homework or other things?" I said, "Well, yes, you're contributing to the class one next year." All right. So we run it like ongoing system. And of course, the annual big events. Join the team environments. Okay. And once you get licensed, we have the Messenger Zoom, we have the field training, we help families. And when you make the first $1,000, right, you become a net license. This is how we call it. And when I look back this year, I don't have too many net license come up. I said, I need to work hard, you know, and starting this month, I need to work harder and help more families and also our associate. That's our extended families too, right? So I want to emphasize one thing, what exactly we are doing here. One major thing is helping people, you know. So I want to share something that in my mind, you know, there's overwhelmingly, there's a majority of people out there, they don't have a plan. Maybe they have some case, they have some policies, right? You know, but they don't have a plan, financial plan. The majority of the industry has left most of this marketplace behind. Okay? So their focus is on the high net worth clients, and here and there, right? Like wealthy families. Well, it doesn't make that a bad company. They just, the way they do, they try to get the best out of it. They try to make more, right? Yeah, but we as a company, we're a financial group, we have a different mindset. We build companies with ordinary people, just like you and me. I think you just mentioned, right? Sonia, so proud of you. Right? We are just ordinary people with the ordinary background. Right? But we help ordinary people too. We help the majority of the population here, right? The marketplace. And some families may have a single policy or multiple policy. You may think, they already have insurance. Oh, they already have annuity. Or they already have their financial advice or whatever, right? Well, they may have a plan. They may have a product, but they don't have a plan, okay? How to get all those products work together to better serve their financial situation? Probably they don't, right? So I kind of feel like, you know, especially the market's volatile, right? There's a war out there and the interest rate goes up, the inflation goes up and a market goes down and all things. You know, the market need has never been greater. And the solutions, the products we represent today have never been better, right? And the thing is, there are fewer people like us willing to talk to the ordinary people, the average family, the daily family, about what their options are and how good the solution could be, and help them understand how to leverage those product solutions to achieve their financial goals. This is a big deal. And this is not happening. This is not happening a lot. So it needs us to help, right? To help people. And I would say the number one family we need to help is ourselves by applying what we learned here, right? So today I learned from the every Monday trainings, every time we put some financial knowledge here today with you, right? Yeah, even though sometimes you say, I don't quite understand. Today is a little bit, you know, there's too much numbers over there. But the thing is, well, in another way is, I can never be like that. But the thing, you don't need to be like that. You're probably very good at talking to people, right? But you know that a lot of people in the business, we studied it and we applied it. And this is proven work. And you can just take the solution, right? On the right-hand side, this is my family's balanced asset allocation. I'm pretty proud, actually, along the decades we built it up, because a lot of tax benefit programs, it takes time to build up. There's always limitations there, okay? So this is what we learned. You don't need to be so technical or number person to really help your family. Same thing. You don't need to be technical or so number person to help a family. There's a family over there, they think long term. They want the overall, right? So I encourage everybody, we help family with a sense of urgency. This is my family's, I just quickly show is all the IUL, VULs I have, right? not including the annuities, right? So I started 2007. When I was 27 years old, that's the month I joined the business. So I joined on license right away and become a 330 net license in a month. So I kind of have a fast start in the business. And if you know my story, I got really hard in the prospecting. So I kind of hibernate for I don't know, a couple months, right? But a good thing I do is Sunny keep telling me, right? Come to the office, yeah? Even though it's a learning and all the things, become a friends and join this extended family. So good things is I joined, and also that 2007 NYKO, I was there, and that changed my mind. And I think no matter how far or how fast I can go in the business, I want to belong to the team. I want to be part of the team. Okay, and so along these years, when my income goes up and build up the business, I basically help my family open up new office policies, myself, my wife, my kid, right? Yeah. And when my kid was born at age zero, I start saving as early as possible. I want to show him a good example of saving money, create a discipline, okay? So then with this business, with this platform, then we got our family have more than 10 million protections. And more importantly, there's a 1 million plus tax-free personal bank. Then I can have the secure in my family, not just in mine, but in Lillian's heart. And also, I didn't tell Ethan, no, not supposed to tell Ethan have the money over there, but whatever. You know, Ethan, we just bought, I think, 2 shares of Tesla a couple of days ago, because he's getting the money with every year, right? Yeah, and we maximize the IUL and VUL, and then I'm teaching him how to have a safety investment and a risky investment at the same time. That's what we teach, right? So if you have a kid, your kid doesn't have a plan yet, start early. We can do it today, right? And I want to show everybody one thing is helping family. Yeah, helping is closing, right? I think Sonia just mentioned that. And I want to add one more thing is helping people with a sense of urgency. You never know. I believe there's the people out there just waiting for me. Not everybody else. Same thing. There's some people over there. They're just waiting for you. Just you. If you're not there, help them. They may miss the opportunity. Right. I want to show you one example. One of my clients, you know, back in 2012, his name is Gordon. Okay. He's a young professional. At the time, he was 27 and I was 32. Okay. So we became friends, and he's an engineer in Qualcomm, San Diego. He's a Cantonese from a little village, right? And his parents, you know, just it's a very humble family. Gordon has a twin sister, right? But the twin sister couldn't go to college because they have to save the money enough for Gordon to go to college and also go abroad to the United States to get the PhD program. So Gordon is the only one in the whole family. The family have the expectations or basically hope in Gordon. Gordon is the hope of the whole family. And he asked me, he said, "Hey brother, why you open an insurance policy at the age of 27? You have no kid, no wife, no house, nothing. Why you open an insurance? You have no insurance need." I said, yes, but there are two things I understand. This kind of tax savings, I want to save tax. And also I want to have a protection because I will have a kid, I will have wife, I will have house later on, right? So because of that, because of me, he was 27, I bought my policy 27, we're friends, right? Someone have no financial, have no insurance need, actually just start working, open an IUL policy. And a start have a start to have a habit of savings. Just not too long, like a couple of years, 5-6 years later, there's one time he called me. He said, "Johnny, can I do a review with you?" I said, "Sure." "Can you double check the beneficiary?" I said, "Yeah, you get married?" No, I didn't get married. It's my parents. If something happened to me, can my parents get the death claim?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Double check the name, everything." Okay. And I was curious, why you ask? I said, "How about we meet together and then let me help you with a review?" When we sit together, you know what? The first sight I saw him, he was bold. He just finished the, what's that called? A cancer, what's that called?
Chemo.
Yeah. And he told me he got diagnosed the level 4 pancreatic cancer, 胰腺癌. And I don't know how to pronounce that. It's so sad, but the thing is, well, he said I'm cured and I'm just recovering. So I thank God that he recovered, right? But just a short after about 4 months, right? And the pastor in his church called me. He said, "Are you the agent of that insurance policy?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Sorry to let you know that Gordon passed away, okay, because of the liver failure and all the things. And once the back covered, it's very bad." So long story short, that shocked me, okay? And he didn't actually have too much. He just have a 401k, one house, one IUL insurance, $1 million. The beneficiary is the parents. So when I saw the parents and also the twin sister and also the niece, the twin sister's son in the US, right? They are still struggling financially back in China, okay? So I know the 1 million is definitely too much compared to the family's hope, right? It's priceless. But I know the 1 million US dollar can help this family, especially help the twin sister and the son for the education or whatever, okay? So that give me the so strong, I think the mission that we are doing here is we're gonna help families with a sense of urgency. I don't know, without me, Gordon, maybe, I don't know if he will get another 27 years old, have the same story, and that triggers him to start saving the IUL, okay? So hopefully we all have that sense of urgency, right? In a sense of urgency, sometimes we get plateaued because of the business, but a lot of time we have this kind of an income thinking. We make good income in the job already. When I was in IT, yes, if there's not 2008, 2009, the market crashed and I got laid off and Sonny told me, "Let's join venture and open an office in San Diego." Probably I still in the cubicle. I still in the cubicle. I think this is just my part-time business as a backup. I probably never think this can be my my mission. This can be something I can devote myself for my lifetime, and this can be my family business, and it can impact so many people later on. I wouldn't have that kind of thinking when I was making good income in the IT consulting field. Okay. But the thing is, when the income, if you struggle on the income like a 50, 40,000 or whatever, yeah, that kind of, you may have the energy or the things, but when your income twice, tripled or whatever to a certain level, we become a comfort. When your income is 2-3 times higher than expenses, it become a comfort, right? Then you go to that mental block right there, it become plateau. And in the business over here, yeah, I like Rich Solly said, plateau is the on-ramp to failure, to going backward. We should refuse that. We should refuse the comfort. But it's hard. I'll tell you it's hard. Okay. When I get to the 500,000, 750, 1 million, right, these milestones, right? Every time I talk to myself, you cannot get to the comfort zone. You know, it's in the running is good and all the things. And, but you know what? The truth is, yeah, I still get a little bit laid back and here and there, okay? So this is something so important, and we can, you know, the something can help is the running. This month, even though it's in holiday season, but Tim Everest in the running mode. Are you in the running mode? I'm not saying you don't have a holiday with your families or whatever. If you have a vacation already set up, if you have already set planned for the last week of this month, try to squeeze all the activities before that, right? Let's do it together. It's for the team pride. And also that's the best way to kill the plateau, to have a breakthrough, to kill the laziness. I like the summary that our great mentor Rocky once put together, right? Then I don't need to create my own. It's we say, why running? It's for long-term building purpose. It's also helping people, helping us, each one of us, right? Increase the ability and then a new generation of leaders to grow the confidence of all what we provide to families. And cultivate positivity, develop fighting spirit, the culture, good habit, get the best of more practice, because you're gonna have more appointments. Trainees will have more training appointments. Trainers will basically have more work with the trainees, more messenger zooms, right? More PAIs appointment setups, and more practice of presentations. Everything that will help you kill the laziness. Set a new standard, we'll have a new bar, we'll have a new, maybe for you it's a new title, a new income level, but more importantly, our team will have a new, basically, identity, okay? And in reflect, there's so many help, so many families' lives will get impact, okay? And out of that, some families, maybe it's the families waiting for you for a long time, and only you can help them. Okay. So that's why I encourage everybody participate in this run, in your SMD's run, in your MD's team's run, your own run. And they have the monitor system to do that. I'm gonna skip this part. Everybody have to do this, right? At the end, I want to quote with the Sunny's this over here. Okay, you know the purpose for running is not for the title, or not for the reward. Yes, but usually it comes with it. But more importantly, is the very best of you and the fighting spirit to the last minute. I remember Ling mentioned there's a one quote, right? Ling said, you know, if 100% is the goal, right? Is the time, for example, the 50% is not half. Normally the half is the 80 or 90%, you reach half. Because the last moment, the last week, the last 2 weeks, the last 3 weeks, now we have last 3 weeks, right? If you have the last week for a holiday, you have 2 weeks. That is basically you can do majority of the goal, majority of the work, 50%. We should never lose faith. and believe that we can make it and fight to the last minute. You know, a culture, we have a culture. A culture is always formed when everybody do the same thing again and again and again. And everyone, everyone is an opportunity to reinforce our team culture. And everyone is a battle. It's a battle of leadership. It's a building. It's operational efficiencies together. It's basically the battle of conquering the self-doubts. That can I do it? Can I make it? And also the laziness. Oh, I'm pretty good already, right? Yeah, let's run next year. Every run, every battle, we add a little bit to our team culture. We cultivate the integrity of team members together. Not just Sunny, Ken, or Ling, or Mark, or Kim Marcel, or Victor, or Jenny, or all the SMDs leaders here. No, it's each one of us that we become team members. So, you know, for the past decades, I'm the witness. Team Everest leaders have had hundreds of this kind of runs in the team, no matter MD run, SMD run, the incomes, the rings, Hawaii, or reward trip, all the things, right? So we have so many examples of running before us to understand that running is not like you like it or you don't like it. It's the critical differentiator of a building and leadership. So the purpose of this running is not just a milestone like a 2 million ring, right? It's not a Sunny's run. It's not Sunny's run. It's our run, actually. It's we leverage the run and build up the business together. It gives each one of us the fighting opportunity to bring the best out of us, out of your team, each one of us, right? How efficient we work together. So it's from the run, how many families' life gonna be changed, including us, also the clients, and how many flag carriers and leaders will emerge during the run, right? So it's much meaningful. So I encourage everyone of us, okay, online today, have a running plan for yourself by the end of this month. Maybe your new is help your own family first to kick off the 30-30 run, right? Maybe it's run for your next promotion or next income milestone, right? No matter how you're in the business, you just joined a business, or maybe you're a little bit frustrated of rebooting your business, I welcome you to be part of this month's movement, right? No matter how much you contribute, it counts to the team pride, right? And I remember Rich Solly said once, is having a goal is like having a world-class mentor whispering to us every day. So we are thankful that the goal setting, even in the holiday season, the execution is the culture of Team Everest, and we are part of that. So we can have this world-class mentor with us every single day, even in the holiday season. We have five leaders reach 1 million income already, okay? So we have 95 to go to reach our Team Everest goal, right? So in the last time Elite Circle, right? I was a little bit shocked, right? But I, when Rich Solly said 95 in the next 2 years, I think that's mission impossible, but what he mentioned that really stretched my mind is it's not just the me or just one person. Rich Solly said, well, all it takes is just need a 95 people of all the attendees. Like today, we have 229 people right now. We just need 95 out of the 200 to think big and dream big, have a go and run for it, right? Do you want to be one of them? But whatsoever, you know, I want everybody to really think about this. Right, this is serious this month. This running is serious, okay? And what is your goal? If you don't have it yet, what is your goal, right? And who you can turn to ask for help to reach the goal, okay? And who are the person, okay, you really want to help the most, right? And together in this month, we're gonna make history and we can do something significant together. Okay, so that's what I want to share. Thank you, Sunny, for giving me the opportunity. Thank you, everybody, for attending all the way to the last minutes, right? Yeah. And let's fight for the new identity. Go back to you, Dan.
Thank you, Jenny, for a wonderful, wonderful session. Thank you, everyone, for logging in. Thank you for staying up to the end. Whoever stays up at the very end always wins. So we are all winners from today. Let's go change the world in the next 2 weeks and make sure we become a 2 million ring and our team come January this year. Thanks a lot. And I look forward to seeing all of you in Houston, January. I'm in Houston, I'm gonna host you. So you're all welcome. I can't wait. Thank you.